this next piece, which I wrote about a year or two ago. It's called Fantasy Variations on All the Pretty Little Horses. And All the Little Pretty Horses, some of you might know, is a lullaby, traditional to the American South. And I've been wanting to write a theme and variations set for a long time. And does anyone know, I know we have some students here, do you know what a theme and variations set is? Does anyone know what that is? Okay, right, some nodding heads, okay. So you basically have a theme that's presented very simply, and then you sort of get that theme presented over and over again, and with each presentation, the composer kind of warms it up a little bit. That's kind of the standard thing, you know, Mozart might do, or Haydn might do, or Beethoven might do. So I've been wanting to write one of these sets for a long time, and I got this shortly after my first son was born. He's three now. Somebody gave us the Metropolitan Museum of Art book of lullabies. And so I was looking through this, and I saw All the Pretty Little Horses. And I read through it on the piano. I was like, this is a very pretty tune. And so I was thinking, well, maybe I could, do something with this and make it a theme and variation set. But there's a problem with using this tune for a variation set. If you know the tune, and as you can imagine, I'm not really going to sing it for you right now. I have many frogs in my throat. It's very repetitive. It's basically the song only has two phrases. Okay. So you only have these two phrases, and the song is like phrase one, phrase one, phrase two, phrase one, phrase one, phrase two. So it's all very repetitive. And if you're going to be writing a theme and variations set, and in any theme and variations set, you're going to hear the tune a lot. You have to watch out for too much repetition, right? There just might be too much of this thing. You hear the song once, and you've already heard the tune four times, because you get that phrase of music four times. So what I felt like I needed to do as a composer is kind of really warm it up a bit, and really stick in some interludes that didn't necessarily have anything to do with the theme, to change keys a lot, to change tempo a lot, and all of this and the other, to make it, not boring and not too repetitive, right? So that was one approach to the music, but then it's like, well, how do you limit, right? You can do so much with a piano, you can do so much in a piece of music. What's going to be your constraint? What are you going to follow? Why are you going to make one choice instead of another? And since I wasn't writing for anybody, I was just writing for myself, I could be like, well, self, what do you want to do? And I thought, well, one thing I like is when pieces of music tell stories. And so I would come up with some narrative to restrict the musical choices. So the narrative is, and the narrative readily suggests itself. My wife, who sang in choirs for a long time, would, before our first son was, going to bed on his own, would rock him in our rocking chair and sing to him and calm him down before he would go to bed. And at first he would resist, right? Because little kids, they never want to go to bed, okay? And he would cry, and he would like, I don't want to go to bed. And but he would, calm down and get more into the music. And that is what I wanted to evoke with the first part of this piece, some kid who didn't really want to listen to the music. Okay. So you'll hear a lot of, kind of trills, right, that are meant to evoke a little infant crying. But, gradually the infant gets more and more into the music, starts listening more, and just sort of gets carried away on the music and falls asleep. So about the middle of the piece you'll hear. asleep. And then, what do you want? What do you want? A dream, right? So a little boy dreaming about riding around on horses, you know, and the parent wants to, you know, check in. We have the dream of the horses. And the parent kind of checks in with him. Is he asleep? And eventually, you know, we sort of figure out that the child is asleep and dreaming of horses, and the piece ends. So that's kind of the idea. You have this narrative, on the one hand, of a child being sung to sleep, falling asleep and dreaming of horses. On the other hand, you have the theme and variations set. So, I hope I didn't talk too much. Please, I hope you enjoy our fantasy variations on All of the Pretty Little Horses.
Thank you.